Alright, I'm Gav, mostly evil, and this is Sharma ji ka, not at all Sharma, Sharminda ladka. Alright, but let's not even talk about RCB, who just booked LSG's ass, but let's talk about Mumbai. And Mumbai's spectacular fall from grace from 5 titles to 0-0-0. So 6 matches, 6 losses, they might as well run away from IPL, like the Indian team ran away from England before the 5th test, ironically, to play IPL. Almost everything that's wrong with the 5-time champions can be directly attributed to a wide range of fuck-ups at the mega auction. Let's start with the $2 million baby, Ishan Kishan. Now, what were you fucking thinking spending 15 CR on Ishan Kishan? Like, it can happen because bidding wars happen sometimes, you can't control it, I understand business. But then high-fiving after buying Ishan 15.25 CR clearly showed that Mumbai think tank is more retarded, if that's even possible, than Manchester United think tank, because these people are just horrible. Okay, not only they paid more than double what he's generally worth, they also killed him with a big price tag special, because this guy simply cannot handle it. Have you seen him? He just keeps crying on the stairs every single time. Here's my 2.2 cents on it, Helmaji ka ladka. Then it's Ishan Kishan has the talent, I don't have any doubt about that, but not the temperament to be a champion or even perform at the right stage. And talent means nothing at the big stage when you don't have the temperament. Please, Sharma ji ka ladka, give me your 2.2 million cents, because that's how much you bet on people and you win millions. That's what you talk about on the curious case of Ish Kish.
Yeah, definitely. I think everything you said is correct. And we have already seen this last season when he was not playing so well. And I think he was thinking that he might not get to the World Cup team. I think it's just a mental block for him. Whenever he stops performing, he goes into some kind of, I don't know, self-loathing or something. I don't know. I mean, he's, as you said, he just almost keeps crying. I think they should work on that, because they have bought him. There's no point cribbing about, or there's no point discussing about why they spent so much money. So now if they have bought him, I think they should work on his mental side of things, because that's where I think the problem lies.
Okay, fine. But this is logical that you can actually work on somebody's mental side. But what about the people who are not even there? Sir Jofra Archer. I mean, how do you work on a mental side of a person who doesn't exist? Spending 8 CR on a player who's not going to play the IPL, and God knows if he will ever play, if he'll be the same person or not. Head scratcher, particularly when you don't have any bloody bowlers. This is a luxury buy they could not afford. I mean, it's like if you already have somebody amazing and then you're buying an extra, I can understand it. But what on earth were Mumbai think tank thinking on this, Vikram or Sharma ji?
I think the whole idea was to build a team for the future. That's why they bought Brevis. That's why they bought Kishan for that ridiculous amount of money. And that's why they bet the house on Jofra Archer. So it's a bet. It's not paying off right now. If Jofra Archer returns back and he's, you know, successful, he's back to his form, even then I think they will still miss a lot of players in other roles, especially the spinner. So yeah, I don't know. I think it was just ego or something that just kept on bidding, going on and on for him, and ended up buying him without any assurance of whether he'll come and play in the next season, because I think they knew that he's not going to play in this season. Yeah, it's just the same problem with when they bought Ishan Kishan. They just spent way too much money, and they spent lot amount of money on the retainees, which was, you know, understandable, because Rohit Sharma is the 5-time winning champion, and the 2 retainees they got for very cheap. But yeah, it just completely screwed up the balance of the team.
Yeah, I think it's a club sandwich of with a lot of instead of mayo or something, they got delusion, they got arrogance, they got stupidity, patty. The patty is stupidity. If there's a burger, I don't know what is wrong with these people. But apart from the Oscars, or which seemed like Oscars for them, they can just buy anything, which is just a simple auction. The deal is everybody has the same purse. Now the big shots who they had, Rosha, Ish Kish, Boom Boom, KP, all 4 haven't risen to the occasion. If players worth 50 CR from a purse of 90 CR flop, you can't be surprised just scroll line that 6-0. Even if you talk about the future or something, but 6-0, 6-2 maybe, 4-2, sorry, 5-1, I mean anything, But I mean, you want to add something? I don't get it. Like, none of them have performed 60. They spent 50 CR on these people. This is more than 60% of the purse.
Yeah, it's just, I think the same thing which we keep talking again and again. It's the balance of the team. They're completely screwed it up. They don't have an all-rounder. They don't have a proper spinner. They don't have a finisher. And all those players who were in those roles, they are doing really well in the other franchises. So
Bolt,
it's just...
Pandya Brothers.
Yeah, Bolt, Sahar. Pandya Brothers, Chahar, all of them. It's just stupidity, or I don't know. I mean, people will come out and say that it's for the future, but the future is now, right? It's you can always build upon it. See, CSK,
Brevis,
right?
Is performing, they have, right? So you buy players like the Brevis. At least they're performing.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, you need
and
then
to.
Then they
mature into, like, you know, into 60, 90, and 100. Now they're making 30.
Right.
That's okay, but you can't be making like what, 7 run in 11 deliveries. We can just buy a Rahane for that matter. We want that. Rahane costs like 50 lakhs, not 15.25 CR, right? And we'll make Rahane wicketkeeper. Yeah. So he'll do everything. He's a team man. So, yeah.
Or even if he's not a wicketkeeper, he'll jump in front of the wicketkeeper and do his job.
Absolutely. I mean, if you still think about right now, there are no replacements. Okay, Rahul Chahar left. M. Ashwin is coming. I mean, honestly speaking, not a bad replacement per se. He's a very, he's been seasoned bowler. When you replace somebody, a big leg spinner in a big team, you want a champion leg spinner. And M. Ashwin is not a champion leg spinner, right? Particularly when you see what leg spinners are doing in the other teams. Now, then you talk about Trent Bolt. Trent Bolt is one bowler they had to replace. And they replace him with four bowlers, by the way. Daniel Sams, Timar Mills, or Timar Mills, however they pronounce it, Arjun Tendulkar, Unadkar. I mean, these all four together don't even come close. What's the point of buying so many? I mean, you're buying somebody else's garbage in Daniel Sams. Arjun Tendulkar, I don't even know if he actually bowls or not bowl. Who knows? Unadkar has been there and thereabouts. Timar Mills have failed in everything. Obviously, they didn't spend too much money on all these people. But what's the point? You buying four people, it's not going to make Trent Bolt. De Kock is one player who's been replaced by Tilak Verma, and both have been at par. Like, if you see the record, I mean, a teenager has done his job immaculately. You can't complain about Tilak Verma, and De Kock hasn't really done great in the other team anyway. So, but Hardik Pandya, if you talk about, then they got Tim David to replace him, an all-rounder, but he's not even playing. So what's the point of paying 8.25 CR if you really believed him? You should put him in the squad. Sometimes they're playing two foreign players. Sometimes they're playing three foreign players. He's still not Tim David, not getting a chance. I don't understand. Now that Hardik is bowling 4 overs every match, he has added insult to MI's injuries. When he's not even playing, he's so active. He's completely like chewing this guy, Gary Kirsten's ear, and they're winning everything. They've won 5 out of 6. It's unbelievable. It's just absolutely unbelievable.
MI supporters come to us and say this is for the future and everything. In your future team and in your current team, the only difference is Jofra Archer. So if your team is so much dependent upon Jofra Archer, then you're never going to win the tournament, because one player can break at any time, right? There could be a situation where Bumrah and both Jofra Archer both are injured. You don't have replacements for them. So it all points to desperation. It all points to cluelessness, that they don't know how to get out of this, because this has never happened. They have lost 5 matches, but that was a different era. Now the competition is there, right? See the table right now. All the new teams are on top, and RCB, who was the butt of all jokes in most recent seasons, and you are nowhere to be seen. That's how tables are turned.
Tables have totally turned, right? Let's talk about the person who's supposed to be the best ever captain in the shorter format. He took over from Virat Kohli. Roshan can't convert starts now. He was not even getting starts if you go by the last match. But all right, you can't control your form. You can't control your luck. Things happen. This is a small format. But you can control your attitude. I have this feeling that it feels like Mumbai just showed up. They've expected that everybody will see their 5 stars, their 5 stars representing 5 trophies, and just roll over. Okay, and that's just like, no, show them their backside and let them just fuck them up the ass, right? Now, if there's one thing sport teaches us, it's that you're only as good as your last performance. And when it comes to performance and attitude, with Rosha, by the way, anybody who's not understanding who's Rosha, Rohit Sharma, so given his fat 16 CR paycheck, has been an abject failure. He hasn't done his job as a batsman. He hasn't done his job as a captain. And that's the reality of right now. I'm not talking about 5 trophies. He's obviously done amazingly before. But right now, in this day, he is nothing. He's an abject failure. This bloke hasn't performed. And by the way, also Ahuja are trying to troll us because the same reason people call people just call TGC racist because they were saying shit about Ashwin. So now people should call us racist also because we don't like Rosha. So whosoever you like, we don't like, become racist. Luckily, we are not white, so we can't be racist. Of course, we're brown. We are not racist. We are the nicest people on earth. This bloke has not performed, Rosha has not performed in 5 seasons. Check the records, for fuck's sake, before talking to us. Check the records. He has not performed in the last 5 seasons. Is Rosha and MI's game over, Bikram, in this edition of IPL? 6 matches, 6 losses.
It shouldn't even be a question that if they're out or not, because they're out. They're at the last position. You cannot rise from that in a highly competitive tournament like this. And you know, every match, I do betting, right, with fake money. Every match the odds are almost equal for both the teams. Every match. Even the betting market is not able to decide which team to pick. SRH, right? The butt of all our jokes. They are in top four now. And coming back to Rohit Sharma, I think, yeah, the reality will dawn now, because people used to criticize Virat Kohli, and we have also criticized Mahendra Singh Dhoni. But both of them, whatever failings they have, they knew how to take a loss. And they knew how to, you know, come back, rise. But I've never seen them, you know, downcast and stuff like how the other captains. And it's just not Rohit Sharma. There is, this guy, Shreyas Iyer. There is Jadeja. Jadeja almost lost it yesterday. So you can see, it's not, people say, oh, make him captain. But captaincy is not an easy thing. Rohit Sharma never saw a failure, right? In IPL, he was so successful. In the Indian team, he was treated as a royalty, right? He got so many chances in Test Arena. And now all the focus is on him. So it will be very interesting to see how he comes out.
I don't know how they didn't see it coming. I've been talking, we started this podcast 2 years ago. We've been talking about Rohit Sharma is going to hit 34, 35 mark. And then it's just going to disappear. Like Viren Sehwag, he was the greatest, and suddenly just within 6 months, it's all go game over. And how did they not see the writing on the wall? They did not qualify for the eight-team competition when they were two-time defending champion for the last 2 times. They didn't qualify for the finals, for the playoffs.
Right.
They didn't see the writing on the wall. Then they're making this team for the future. Whose future? There is no future. Rosha is going to get kicked out. But there's no future. There is no future. This is just as good stupidity as SRK did with letting go Faf du Plessis and making Ravindra Jadeja captain, and because he's not a captaincy material. Ravindra Jadeja is one of the genuine all-rounders. He's not a fake Shankar guy who's like the 3D. This guy is genuine 3D. Amazing, amazing fielder, amazing bowler, amazing batsman now as well. But when you make him a captain, then he's just finished. He's like, what the fuck is this? You ruined him. You're just going to ruin him. I think it's just like a... Oh, but the only silver lining I see is that Sky, I love this guy. I mean, he's very dependable. And then AB Ravi, completely swashbuckling. He doesn't care. He does not give a rat's ass. He just comes out and starts hitting like there's no tomorrow. I think he's going to hit 100 for like 30 odd deliveries, and it's going to be one of the best matches and the only match that Mumbai will win.
MI will win.
Yeah, I'm not even sure they'll win that match, but he'll make 100 and probably they'll still end up losing that match because they're such kind of idiots. Because what is with everybody keep taking bowling and everybody losing now? I think this is the last 5-6 matches constantly on the trot, people have lost after bowling.
Right.
When will they learn, man? When will they learn? It is just a nightmare. It's just terrible.
Yeah, I think whatever they're doing is working. I don't think the dew is becoming such a big factor now. I don't see so much water in last 2-3 matches. So whatever they're doing or whatever environmental stuff is going on, I think the situation has become better. So I think, yeah, people need to reconsider taking bowling.
Yeah, I mean, I just see everybody's losing. I mean, it's out last 10 matches, 7 matches won by a team who is actually batted first. So, and then every time you're just getting to choose, you're choosing to bowl first. It doesn't make any goddamn sense. So it's like, it's just completely stupid. And a couple of matches which is won by the second team won, it's like what happened to CSK. They should have never lost that match in the first place. So it was just terrible.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I mean, let's see what happens from now. I mean, it can only go up, right? They've already hit the rock bottom. So this is season over, but if Mumbai really doesn't get their heads out of their asses, I think they could well be the next Manchester United of cricket. Like, terrible, terrible. Or let's just say, probably right now they're behaving more like Everton of cricket, and they're trying to get relegated. But yeah, that's all from me, Gav, and Sharma Ji ka Londa. Lauda would have been better name than that. It was back to troll Mumbai when they lose their seventh match on the bounce, which will be in 2 days. Till then, like and subscribe. Don't forget.
Or we'll troll CSK.
Yeah, we'll troll everybody. Jai Jawan, Jai Pakistan, and CSK. I'm wearing CSK colors. I don't know if people notice. That's how you troll people, by wearing their colors, getting their homies in. All right, that's all from us. Take care. See you next time. Bye bye.